Hey guys, how's it going? I think this is a great time for folks looking to buy a budget or a mid-tier laptop. This is because both Intel and AMD are making available their best quad-core CPUs for the budget and the mid-tier laptops. So for a while, these CPUs could be found only on premium laptops like Microsoft's Surface Laptop 3 or the Dell XPS 13. But now you can get Intel's 10th generation Ice Lake CPU in select mid-tier laptops. And I've got one of these laptops here with me today. This is HP Notebook 15, and it brings Intel's 10th generation Ice Lake CPU at a $599 price point. Now, the price on Amazon tends to fluctuate, so please check out the links that I have put in the video description below for the latest price and availability of this laptop. So let's put HP Notebook 15 through 10 rounds of grueling test. By the end of this video, we will know if this laptop is worth its price. So let's get started. HP Notebook 15, it weighs 3.75 pounds and it is only 0.7 inches thick. So for a 15.6 inch laptop, this is a fairly thin and light profile. You can easily toss this laptop in your backpack and carry it around without any issues. So at a first glance, this laptop looks like a high-end premium machine. It comes in royal silver metallic color with matte finish, which does a good job of repelling, you know, fingerprint smudges. There is a silver colored HP logo at the center of the top lid, nicely complementing the overall look. The body is made of polycarbonate, but HP has reinforced the chassis with aluminum sheet, giving it plenty of structural rigidity. So the edges have smooth curves, which not only look good in my opinion, but they also feel very comfortable when you're holding the laptop in your hands. So when you open this notebook, you are greeted with a 15.6 inch screen, and the screen has minimal bezels. These bezels are matte black in color, and I think they nicely contrast with the silver color of the laptop. HP has really nailed the aesthetics on this laptop. There are no gaudy logos or stickers anywhere. Even the Intel Core i5 sticker, which is usually blue in color, it's actually silver in color and it nicely fades into the background. The keyboard island and the palm rest are both silver in color, but the keys have a soft matte finish, while the palm rest, it has this brushed metal finish and it shows off these vertical brushing patterns, which I think it looks really nice. Overall, I'm very impressed with the design and the build quality of this laptop. Compared to similarly priced laptops from Acer, Asus, and Dell, I think HP has hit the ball out of the park. So I would have to say good job HP on the build quality. This laptop comes with a 15.6 inch Full HD widescreen display. It's an LED backlit IPS panel with an anti-glare matte coating. Now guys, I'm a big fan of matte finish because it helps cut down the glare and reflections. Now the screen on this laptop is of average brightness, maxing out at 220 nits of brightness. So when using this laptop in my home office, which is actually a pretty bright lit area, I had to crank up the screen brightness to about 85%. I think you will be able to use this laptop in a classroom or an office space at high brightness without any issues. But outdoors is going to be a struggle because this screen is not bright for, you know, using this laptop outdoors. Now, I wish HP had made the screen little more brighter, but, you know, at this price point, I see a lot of laptops are, you know, around 220 to 250 nits of brightness. And I would say this laptop is on the average brightness scale. Okay, now let's talk about the color reproduction. So when it comes to colors, this screen does a fairly good job. Pictures and videos look bright and colorful. While the 45% NTSC color gamut is not going to win any awards, I think it's good enough for watching videos and, you know, movies on YouTube and Netflix, and also checking out pictures on Instagram. The bezels on this display are really slim and they give this laptop a very modern look. The side bezels measure only 6.5 millimeter, giving this laptop a screen to body ratio of 82%. I think that's very impressive for a laptop in this price range. So overall, I think this is a pretty good display, not only for media consumption, but also for productivity tasks, you know, like word processing and web browsing. But note one thing, guys, this is not a touchscreen display. So if you are looking for a touchscreen laptop, I would recommend checking out my 2-in-1 laptop review playlist linked in the video description below. This playlist contains detailed reviews of my pick of 2-in-1 laptops from companies like Dell, Acer, and Lenovo. I will also drop purchase links to all these laptops in the video description below if you are interested in checking out their current price and availability. Okay, now let's talk about the CPU. HP Notebook 15, it's powered by a 10th generation Intel Core i5 processor. So specifically, this is Core i5 1035G1 from Intel's Ice Lake family. So this CPU is built using Intel's latest 10 nanometer process technology. It's a quad core processor with hyper threading enabled. So that means you are getting 8 execution threads, which is awesome for multitasking. Now, for the longest time, Intel would disable hyperthreading on their budget CPUs, but thanks to increased competition from AMD, Intel is now, you know, changing its tune and it's enabling hyperthreading on all their CPUs. So this CPU, it has a base clock frequency of 1 GHz and max turbo frequency of 3.6 GHz. Even though 1 GHz base clock frequency, it sounds kind of low, but this CPU, it delivers excellent performance. And this is because Intel has dramatically improved the IPC on Ice Lake family CPUs. So IPC, if you guys are not familiar, it stands for instructions per clock, and it represents the amount of work a CPU can do in one clock cycle. So Ice Lake CPUs, they can do more work at a low clock frequency, and therefore they are able to deliver kick-ass performance, and they also give you very good battery life. So for example, let's compare this processor with Intel's last generation Core i5 processor, which is actually clocked at 1.6 GHz. So you would think that a 1.6 GHz Core i5 processor, it would be faster than a 1 GHz Ice Lake processor. So let's look at some benchmarks. In Passmark benchmark rating, Core i5 1035G1 clocked at 1 GHz, it scored 7,937 points, while the last generation Intel chip clocked at 1.6 GHz, it managed to score only 6,311 points. So that means Ice Lake CPU is 25.8% faster than the last generation Intel chip. I think HP has picked an awesome CPU that delivers great performance at low 15 watt thermal envelope, resulting in extended battery life. So you will have no trouble running any application on this laptop, whether you are doing casual internet surfing or watching YouTube videos or running productivity apps, you know, stuff like Microsoft Office. This laptop will breeze through all these tasks without any issue. Okay, now let's talk about the GPU. So this laptop is using Intel's integrated UHD graphics. This is a power-efficient GPU suitable for casual gaming, multimedia playback, and lightweight photo and video editing. So the base clock speed on this GPU is 300 MHz, and the max dynamic frequency is 1.05 GHz. So I played Fortnite at low setting, and I was able to get average frame rate of about 40 to 45 FPS. The frame rate maxed out at about 60 FPS, which I think is good enough for a smooth Fortnite session. Now this GPU, it supports hardware acceleration of all popular codecs. So codecs like H.264, AVC, AV1, and VP9, all these codecs are hardware accelerated. And so that means you are going to get smooth video playback, including 4K video playback on YouTube, Netflix, and other services like Disney Plus. You will have no dropped frames, and you know the videos are going to play stutter free. But guys, remember one thing, at the end of the day, this is still an integrated GPU. So don't expect Nvidia and AMD discrete GPU class performance. If you plan to do hardcore gaming, you are probably better off buying a gaming laptop. So I've already reviewed plenty of awesome gaming laptops here on this channel, and I will throw a link in the description if you want to check out these reviews. And I have reviewed gaming laptops from many OEMs. So check out the link in the description below if you are into gaming. Okay, now let's talk about the system memory and onboard SSD storage. So HP Notebook 15, it comes with 8 GB of system RAM and 256 GB of fast PCIe NVMe SSD. Unfortunately, the RAM is not user upgradable and it kind of sucks, but at least there is 8 GB RAM. So, you know, that should be fine for most folks. I was able to run over 20 Chrome browser tabs and switch seamlessly between them without any issues. The laptop always felt very snappy when running productivity apps like word processor and Excel sheet. When it comes to expanding onboard SSD storage, HP does offer a second M.2 slot for adding another SSD. This is really awesome because very few laptops in this price range offer a second M.2 slot. So I will drop a link of compatible PCIe NVMe SSD that work with this laptop, and if you are interested in adding a second drive. Okay, now let's talk about the battery life. HP Notebook 15 comes with a 3-cell 41-watt-hour battery, which coupled with this power-efficient Ice Lake CPU gives fantastic battery life. So HP claims over 10 hours of battery life, but in my testing, I managed to get about 8 hours of battery life, you know, doing typical web surfing with the Wi-Fi turned on. I also tried continuous video playback at 50% brightness and I had Wi-Fi turned off. And by doing that, I got almost 9.5 hours of battery life, which is really impressive. This battery supports fast charging, so you can juice it up from 0 to 50% in under 45 minutes. So this long battery life coupled with fast charging, I would say that this is an all-day laptop. And I think this is an ideal laptop for students and also for working professionals on the go. Regarding thermal heat dissipation, the laptop never overheated for me. Now the fans kicked in during heavy workload, but it was not dramatically loud. I think the power efficient 10 nanometer Ice Lake chip is responsible for, you know, really good thermal performance of this laptop along with its long battery life. Okay, now guys, let's talk about the keyboard. So this laptop, it comes with a full-size island-style keyboard. The keys are silver-colored and nicely complement the overall aesthetics that HP is going for. So the keyboard island, it sits slightly lower than the palm rest, and this allows the keys to have a good travel distance while still not touching the screen when you, you know, close the laptop. So the keys, I think they are reasonably large size keys. They are nicely balanced and they are quite responsive. They offer an actuation force of about 75 grams, which results in nice typing experience. These keys stay very quiet during typing, which makes this an excellent laptop for students taking notes in the classroom. Obviously, all the schools are closed right now because of the current situation. But you know, whenever the classrooms open, you guys will enjoy, you know, taking notes with this laptop in your classroom without disturbing your professor. Now, I really enjoyed the tactile feedback that I was getting, and I was able to hit my maximum typing speed after like 10 minutes of practice on this keyboard. So this keyboard deck, it has a brushed metal finish and it offers a smooth resting surface for your palm when you are doing long typing sessions. So overall, I would say that this is a fantastic keyboard and it punches way above its weight. Okay, now let's talk about the trackpad. So it's a fairly large trackpad. It measures 4.5 inch by 2.5 inch. While it's made of plastic and not glass, it's quite clicky. The surface is very smooth and I did not have any trouble scrolling web pages. The laptop comes with Windows Precision drivers, and this is really important because this means it supports all the Windows 10 gestures. So stuff like pinch and zoom, you know, double tap for right click and customizable three finger gestures, they all worked without any problems. Overall, I think this is a pretty decent trackpad with just the right size. I think any larger and it would interfere with your typing, and any smaller and you would have trouble scrolling web pages. Okay, now let's talk about the webcam. This feature has been neglected by laptop makers for almost a decade. But now, you know, in this age of working from home, I think webcams have become a really important feature. So this laptop, it comes with a 720p webcam and it has a dual microphone setup. So using noise reduction software, this dual mic system, it actually does a very good job capturing pretty decent audio. And I think this is great for video chats and for conference calls on services like, you know, Zoom and Skype. But I do wish that laptop makers, they start putting a higher quality, you know, at least a 1080p webcam. You know, when you get a cheap $300 Android phone and that phone has a better webcam than a typical $800 laptop, then I think something is really wrong. Okay, now let's talk about the speakers. So I think HP has done a really good job with the speakers here. This laptop, it comes with top firing stereo speakers and they are really loud. So for a budget laptop, I am very impressed with these speakers. They are a great speaker set for, you know, watching YouTube videos, Netflix videos, and also for listening, you know, music. Now the laptop, obviously it comes with a headphone jack. So you are welcome to use a high quality wired headphones if, you know, if you're planning to game or if you're planning to watch a movie or indulge in some, you know, private listening. Okay, now let's talk about ports. So this laptop, it comes with plenty of ports and I'm glad that HP has not cut any corners here. So you get one USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-C port supporting data speeds up to 5 gigabits per second. Unfortunately, the USB Type-C port does not support power delivery. So that means you cannot charge this laptop using the USB Type-C port and you will have to carry the traditional charger for this laptop. You also get two USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-A port and this is for connecting old school USB devices, you know, including external mouse, keyboard and USB drives. This laptop also supports the latest Wi-Fi 6 standard, which will give you the fastest and the most robust wireless internet connection, assuming that you already have a compatible router. It also supports Bluetooth 5.0, which I really love because this allows connecting multiple Bluetooth devices to this laptop. You also get an HDMI port for hooking this laptop to an external monitor. I was able to connect this laptop to my 4K monitor and create a kick-ass dual screen setup. The laptop had no trouble driving 4K resolution at 60 frames per second. I think this is really useful for folks who are working from home and who would like to take advantage of dual screen setup to boost their productivity. Last but not the least, HP Notebook 15, it also comes with a full-size SD card slot, which is great for folks like me who routinely need to transfer pictures and videos from their mirrorless camera to PC. So overall, I think HP has all your bases covered when it comes to port selection. Okay, so what do I think of this laptop? I think for $599, HP has got a winner in their hands. You are getting the latest Intel CPU offering great performance and battery life. You are getting a good quality 1080p screen. You are getting a great keyboard and a trackpad. And there are plenty of ports. The only negative that I can think of is the lack of user upgradability when it comes to system RAM. HP should learn something from Acer Aspire 5 laptop, which is one of my favorite laptops. And the reason I love that laptop is because you can upgrade both the RAM and the SSD and you can do it very easily. So that's it for today, guys. What do you guys think about this HP Notebook 15? Please let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more content like this. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops and gaming PCs. Again, guys, thanks for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.